Hello and welcome back to another tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to create photorealistic landscapes extremely quickly inside of Cinema 4D and Octane Render. You won't need to know anything when it comes to modeling or texturing or any of that. Just a little bit of basics of how materials work and how to import some assets into Octane. And you should be able to create these for yourself too. So we use these methods when it comes to generating landscapes and generating like forestry and environments for our commercials and things like trailers and stuff like that. These methods are very, very useful and I'm gonna show you how to do them extremely fast. So the only software you'll need is really Quixel Megascans, and then you can use whatever software you prefer to use, whether it's Blender, Cinema 4D, whatever render you prefer to use. It should all just work the same. So we've gone and imported some sticks just to scatter around our scene, so different variations of sticks, and as well as a bush which will just scatter around as well, and then that's pretty much it. So all you need is a plane to put your landscape textures on, and then we're going to use Quixel Mixer here. Now you can go create a new project and like generate your own landscape, but here there's actually some presets that you can use. So here we've got wet mud and like some jungle room floor and all that. We're going to use some wet mud because that's got like some nice reflections and stuff and a lot to look at. So here you can kind of see we've got like a little preset thing kind of set up here, and you can kind of rotate the around scene and stuff as you would in like a 3D scene. The controls might be slightly different, but for the most part it's the same. The great thing about this is you can turn things on and off depending on what you actually want. You can turn off the water, turn it on, turn off the moisture, turn it on, and you also have a lot of controls of how much water you want and what it should affect and which things it should affect. Then you can also add some different layers in here. So once you add in some layers, it'll actually import from the Quixel Megascans library, so you can add in some stones and rocks and stuff. So we tend to mix these elements together to provide to generate the kind of environment that we want. I've used this on the Soul Drop commercial, and I've used this on other clients' projects like trailers and stuff like that. And it's very, very effective to get you a very, very photorealistic looking environment. So once you've done all your stuff and you've played around in here and you've done all that, all you need to do is go and export it. So firstly, you'll need to make sure that you've got your correct map. So you'll need albedo map, which is basically like a diffuse or a color map, a roughness map for some of your reflections, a normal map, displacement map, and that's pretty much all you need. You can add some different maps here as well. Here you can choose like the type of file type and stuff like that, and then you can also choose if you want messiness and other options here if you're using a different software and it requires certain things. But this is the gist of what we'll need. So we're going to export at 8K just for the highest resolution, so you can kind of see what it'll look like at its peak. And we're going to go pick a folder here that we want to export this to. So I'm going to export this to my landscape tutorial and my assets, select. And here you can even add the resolution to your file names. There's a lot of options. So we're just going to go and do that and say export for maps. It's very, very simple. Everything's made for you. You don't need to know how to use the software. I figured it out very, very fast. So hopefully you'll be able to do the same. So we're going to let this import. And while that's doing that, I mean export while it's doing that, we're just going to set up a little bit of Octane here. So open our live viewer, bring this in. We're going to use some basic sunlight lighting here and just gonna have it sitting somewhere like there, and then that's it. And now that our textures have imported, we're gonna create a glossy material. We're gonna apply it to our floor, and then we're just gonna bring in our textures here. So we're going to bring in our image texture here for our diffuse. So if I just go here, this is our albedo map, like so. And then all we really want to do is make sure that our texture here is set on cubic so that it's forming in squares and not really affected by the UVs of the actual ground here. So the next thing we'll bring in is our displacement map, just because that's what's going to make the biggest difference. So we'll just go paste this in our displacement and then bring in our displacement map here. And also might be a good idea to bring in your displacement maps as EXR files so that there's more information in them, stuff like that. But PNG is fine for most people. We're going to bump this up to 8K so we get all the little qualities that we want. And then we're just going to set this down to a realistic level here. So here you can see there's some like weird bumpiness going here. And this could be your actual type, your file type. So here you, in your displacement settings, you might want to change this to like an EXR and then go 32-bit instead of 16-bit because that can also affect things. So if we just go and untick these and just re-export an EXR map, we should get some more information in our file that a PNG might be limited to. So we're just going to let that come through, and then we're just going to re-import this EXR file. Okay, it might be still exporting. Let's try again. Okay, it's still being, it's still exporting. Let's let it finish quickly. It's an 8K resolution thing, so it might take a little bit of time. And I believe it might be done. Okay, so now it's done. We go and re-import this one. And then we'll see if that makes a difference or not. And I'm just showing this because some of you might run into these issues, so it'll be good to for me to fix these while I'm doing it. So now you can see there's already an improvement on the visual. And here you can also control, instead of setting an auto, you can control of like how many bits it should have when it's importing here and all that. And if it still doesn't look great, you can adjust this. You can go like geometric normal, play around with these, or smooth normal, whichever one looks best. You can even add some blurring and all sorts of stuff like that. So we're just going to set this to a actual reasonable amount. So drop this down, and the scale also might be too big. For our scene, it depends on what your real world scale is. So we're going to actually have a figure here for reference. So now you can kind of see what this real world scale is looking like. Then we just need to bring this up again, maybe go 10, 5, 10, something like that. We can get rid of this figure here. Then we can go and copy our diffuse, put that inside of our roughness map as well. So here's our roughness map. These are very high resolution textures, so you might struggle depending on your PC setup. And then also have our normal map inside here. So the more layers, the better, generally provides more detail. And then your camera angles here is very important. But firstly, I'm going to make sure that my render settings are the optimal settings here. So I'm just going to reload that so that we've got our linear settings and path tracing and all that. Then we're going to adjust this camera angle to something that's more pleasing, maybe like here. Like here. So we're going to go very close to the ground because we want to make sure that all the details are showing. Then what we should do next, I think, is start to scatter some things around. So here, maybe I should get rid of the textures. We're going to go and bring in an octane scatter. So I can't find it here, so I'm just going to go scatter. Boom. We're going to put our bush in our octane scatter. We're going to make our floor the surface. We're just going to change this to surface. And now we've got some bushes scattered around, so we can do the same for our sticks. Copy this. We're just going to delete our bush and then just drag all these sticks in here. So now we've got our sticks as well. And then all we need is a bit of random and variation. So here we're going to bring in a random effector and make sure that both of these are being affected. And then our random effector will only won't affect the Y position, only this X position. So if we go 250, 250, and maybe let's remove it off the bushes and just the sticks here, something like that. Then you can change the seed around depending on where you want the sticks to sit. So here might be a good place for me. Then all we need to do is now make this look like a really filmic kind of thing. Again, it depends on what you're going for, but here we're getting our black bars. We'll change this to maybe Panavision. And then we just need a little bit of depth of field. So maybe this up, something like that. Now you can kind of see how much detail is actually in the ground here. So maybe if I increase this just for the tutorial's sake, so you can kind of see what's going on, increase some of this post here. And then here I can even start to do a little bit of color grading. This is better to do in post, but here you can like increase the saturation, increase the brightness here a little bit. And then where your sun is facing is really important, because this will make a huge difference depending on the maps that you've got put in. So here you can see this doesn't look great. It looks ugly, looks blown out, but maybe if I adjust it off to the side here, it looks a little bit better. And then if I drop the sun a little bit, there'll be a little bit more of a sunset. So here you can have like a very nightish scene, have like some area lights or like a moon or something like that. So here's like a very dark scene here. Might want to bump up the exposure a little bit. This looks really good already. There's so many ways you can go, and I think I might actually just end it here because this looks great. And then if you want just to add in some more detail, I don't believe I have trees and stuff here, but you can even just go and bring in some trees here. So if I go and bring in this trees here, this is from other projects that I've worked on. You can like take your tree stump here, and these have all taken from Quixel Megascans. Sometimes I get them from other sources, but Quixel Megascans is a great place to get them. So now if we bring in everything, the problem with the 8K resolutions, it's going to take a while to just import into your Octane Live View. So that's the downside, but you with the quality, that's what you're sacrificing. So boom, bring that in. Now I've got some trees in the background and all that. And yeah, there's so much you can do with this. Like there's a lot of options. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. Let me know if you have any questions. If you want to check out the free professional workflow guide, that's in the description. I'll put this specific project up on Patreon as well, if you guys want to download this and you don't want to try and make it yourself, including all the assets and all that. It's very simple. You don't need anything extravagant, just Cinema 4D and Octane to use these. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like if you did. Hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you on my next tutorial. Goodbye.